Hi, and welcome to this new video. My name is Sylvia, and today we will see together how to create a land survey. So, let's get started. Imagine that you want to provide your clients with a land survey for their newly designed home and want to show the terrain layout, the building layout, and the outdoor elements. So we select the project. We already created the ground floor, as you can see. And to start creating our land survey, we need to tap on Add Floor, and voila! Here we have the option Land Survey. We tap on Add. I tap on Add again, Object, and voila! I select the terrain layout. Now I just tap somewhere in the blank space and I start drawing my terrain layout. Here we go. If we then go here on the option Edit Corners, we can also see the angle degree of each corner. We can decide to move them around, right? We can make our terrain layout bigger. Here we go. And we can also decide to add a corner. For example, we tap on the line and we select the option Add Corner. And voila, we can pull it out, for example. And let's see. Okay, we have our terrain layout ready. But now we want to add our building layout on it. So we go on Add, Object, and in Outdoors, we have the option Building Layout. Now we can decide if we want to draw it manually, we would select No. Or if we want the app to generate the building layout automatically based on the ground floor, and we say Yes. If we see that the building layout is a bit bigger, it's not a problem. We can select the terrain layout, we select Edit Corners, and we make it the right size. Once our terrain layout and the building layout are in the right position, we can tap on the terrain layout and we can start adding our outdoor objects. So we go here on Add, Objects, Outdoors, and for example, we could add a pool. We can, of course, rotate it. We can put it here and we can add some more objects. For example, a palm tree, we can put it here and we can also go on duplicate and add more palm trees. Let's add one more. And we can maybe add also a brick path to enter our house. So we go on Add, Objects again, Outdoors. And here we have the brick path. I will put it here to make it bigger. You just need to tap on it with your fingertips and resize it. I zoomed in so that you can see how it works. You select the brick path and you make it a bit longer so that it fits your needs. Once you're happy with your land survey, you may want to set the distance of the building in relation to the side. So you just need to tap on the building layout and here on the corner you see set distance. We tap on it. And we select one point of our building, for example here, and then we tap on the terrain layout. We have set the distance. And if we are on site and we want to be very precise, we can tap on the blue number. And we could also decide to connect a Bluetooth laser meter to have 100% accuracy in our measurements. And one additional note, except for outdoor elements, depending on your subscription type, if you go on Add, you will also have the option to add photos. And in the object category, you will also have the option to add some annotations to your project. Good, but now let's take a look at our project in 3D. And voila. And last but not least, if we go back to our project level, we can also export our project and see where the land survey is displayed. We tap on the blue page, for example, near Report PDF. Voila, let's take a look. If we go here on the bottom of our project, you will be able to see your land survey displayed. And also with the sketch PDF, if we tap on the blue page, we let the app load our project and let's take a look. Here we go, we have our beautiful page displaying the land survey. One additional note, what you saw here is my simulator, which is a developer's tool but it works exactly the same as the real app. The only difference is that I use the mouse, but you can of course use your fingertips on a mobile device. And that's it. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and that you now know how to create your own land survey. And I will see you in our next video. Bye.